I am Chef Roshan Pauly, Director, Chef, HOD and Celebrity Chef of Garden City College. We in our syllabus are introducing Indian progressive menu as a part for students to learn. This is the first time in Asia we are introducing this. Indian progressive cuisine means breaking down the traditional elements of cooking. With me today I have my students from first semester Vikas, third semester Vijayant and third semester Surya. Okay, so today we're making a dish called your favorite butter chicken, but what we are naming it as butter out of the chicken. So completely crazy concoction of flavors from your traditional Punjab. There's a bit of Mexico and a basic Brazilian cooking involved in this. Okay, so this is the dish we're going to use. We have with us chicken breast that has been cut slantingly. It's approximately 100 grams or one big boneless breast. Tomato puree, tomato paste, ginger garlic paste, chopped onion, diced onion, diced as I told you, cut onion, peel it, pull the skins out or flesh out, diced cap peppers, you can use red, green, yellow, depends on your color and standards, chopped garlic, whole garlic, okay, whole tomatoes for the gravy base, coriander, kasturi methi, thyme, dry spices I'm using is bay leaf, I'm using cinnamon, I'm using star anise and ilachi, all just one number for the flavor. Dry red chilies, Kashmir chili powder, no cumin, only in this cumin powder, no coriander powder, no turmeric, okay, no pepper and only bit of salt. So first we make the chicken pieces, then we make the gravy, or first we'll do the gravy, the chicken pieces, and then we'll make the sauce. Okay, so this is how we begin. First thing is we take the chicken. Okay, see exactly I'm using one, squeeze out all the moisture you can. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, then to this I add curd. That's 1 tablespoon of curd. Okay, lime juice, a half quarter of a lime, olive oil, 1 tablespoon, Kashmiri chili powder, I'm adding 1 big teaspoon, salt to taste, okay, and then a little bit of ginger garlic paste, that's 1/4 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste I'm using. That's it I'm using, okay, mix it. Now in meantime we'll make the sauce. Pan, in goes olive oil, that's 2 tablespoon olive oil, butter goes in 1.5 tablespoon, in goes in 1 bay leaf, 1 cinnamon bark, 1 ilachi and 1 star anise. Let it crackle a bit. Okay, in this to it I add 1 big heaped tablespoon of chopped onion, and then these are my tomatoes, they directly go in. Okay, got it, they directly go in. Then to this I add kasturi methi, 1 tablespoon. Then to this I add tomato puree, 2 tablespoon, dry red chilies, 3, look, whole garlic, 4 cloves. You can even add a bit of cashews if you like to get the rich silky gravy. Let us add some cashews to see the taste. So when these are cooking in the high heat, take a knife, start cutting your tomatoes, see. Okay, slowly start cooking. Let this cook approximately for 20 minutes. Okay, so meantime when this cooks, we will make a chicken. Now that's the chicken that has been marinated. Okay, this is the chicken that has been marinated. For better effects, take a knife, slowly poke them. Got it? So the flavors will infuse in the chicken properly. Okay, Correct. Meantime, shoot the gas there. On the heat. Slow the heat down. Come, Jerry. In the pan, goes in. That's it. 1 teaspoon olive oil. Coat the pan well. Okay. Got it? Okay. If you're in a house, use a non-stick pan. Just slowly move the pan if it's difficult for you. Okay. In will go the chicken. Okay. I don't want the pan to be too hot. That will burn the chicken out of waste. And interior, it won't cook. The extra marinade, reserve it, dab it on the chicken, and then leave it on slow, cook on slow heat. So meantime, as the chicken is being fried, the mixture of the tomato and the cashews have gone to a mixture to blend well. Okay? Once they blend, they form a smooth texture. Remember to chill it and then paste it. Okay? So as the chicken is frying, to this I will add my peppers, that is 2 tablespoons, and diced onion. Okay, once it's done, we'll take it out, give it a toss. Okay, add a pinch of lemon juice to this. Okay, increase the heat now. So this is done. We'll begin the next process. Come through here. Now to this pan I add the puree mixture. Why do we do this? We don't want the sediments to hurt the throat or the mouth of the people who are eating this, okay? So as the gravy is straining, let the pan remain on high heat. So this won't be a thin gravy, it will be a very thick gravy. This will go with rotis, sometimes with palau, but not with white rice. As the gravy is bubbling, to this I add butter chicken, right? 1 teaspoon butter, 1 tablespoon, is how you like it. Kashmir chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon for the color. Salt, a pinch of powdered sugar. It depends on your taste, how you like it. A little bit of cumin powder. It's not necessary, but you could add it for your Indian touch. Okay, so as the sauce bubbles out, now to this I add the fried chicken and the peppers. Okay, see that? Okay, so as the gravy is bubbling, now I add Indian fantasy cream. Welcome to Punjab. So that's your 1.5 tablespoon. Another 1 tablespoon. Chalo. Today is the cholesterol and calorie festival. Okay, coriander. Let's cook it well. As I told you, to make a good chef, you need to taste your dish. Okay, I do taste always, but you better you taste. Mix it well. Okay. See, these are dishes being prepared by our students. So just an amateur cooking where you also can learn, anybody can cook this dish. There's nothing called here as rocket science. Okay, done. Give it a twist. Okay. Best way, don't burn your tongue. It needs a little bit more salt. Okay. Bit more salt. I would suggest a pinch of black pepper because I like it a little bit spicy. It's too bland for my tongue. Okay, so they're done. As the gravy boils, you can see the texture. Okay, it's not that easy to pour even. I want it more thicker, so I increase the gas. Okay, done, we're done. So now you plate it. So take your plate. As I told you, always take a clean plate. Give me some tissues. Okay. Use a bowl, use anything you like, okay? Depends on your comfort. Clean it well. Okay. I'm using this plate because it looks fancy. If you don't have this in your home, you could use a normal bowl, which is a china bowl. Okay. Take out a chicken. Okay. See, I'm removing all the gravy from the chicken. I'm making it look like a chicken stack steak, but Indian style. Okay. Then. See what I'm doing? I'm placing all the gravy out. Okay. Then I take the sauce. I spoon the sauce in the side. Don't worry about that. I'll get it cleaned up. Okay. So I exactly added chicken of 6 pieces and sauce of 5.5 spoons. Take a bit of cream. Okay. Put a big dab of cream on the gravy. That's where you call your makhni, your sauce. Okay. Pinch of butter on the sauce. Okay. Chop coriander on the plate. Okay. Sometimes people do like lemon in this. You could add it. Okay. Pinch of chili flakes. Okay. Spoon of olive oil. There, we are done. Healthy and fatty. Thank you.